Hey there, I am using a voice to speak to do my video today because I have a hard time saying what I want to say when I get in front of the camera, and I have seen lots of YouTube videos using a computer to do the talking for them, so here it goes. You all have seen my other videos and know I have OCD and trichotillomania, but I get shy when I go into more detail. Just being vague about it. Before we go on any further, please like this video. If I get 20, I will finally do a video showing my trichotillomania. And don't forget to smash that subscribe button and the bell so you will not miss another video. Trichotillomania is a mental disorder where you have the urge to pull hair out anywhere on the body. For me, I pull just about everywhere, with the hair on my head the worst. I can't remember when I started, just that I have been doing it since I can remember. I have been under a lot of stress lately and let my trichotillomania get worse. The worst in my hair pulling ever. I can control myself until I am watching TV or being on the computer. My brain, hands, and mouth are so used to the action and the relief I'd feel after pulling that my pulling sessions can last for hours. While I try not to draw attention to myself doing it. Being stressed out and pulling where it hurts the most feels good to me. Like I get relief. T is a mental disorder, and about 4% of the population have it, yet a lot of them do not admit it. I have been to therapy for it, but I have never told my primary doctor about it. I have been too shy about it, thinking my doctor would look at me funny. I have been on a lot of different medicines, but so far none seem to help. And only a few people in my life growing up knew what I did, and most were family living together, and they made me see help. As you can see from these pictures, growing up it was not so bad. I still had short hairs, but I did not pull so much. But after having a kid, the urge got worse, and I think about it all the time. And it is hard to talk to someone who doesn't struggle with trichotillomania, because they don't know what it's like or how I feel or what I go through every day. We shouldn't be tearing each other down because some of us struggle with mental disorders and others are perfect. We should lift each other up, helping each other. What do you accomplish by being mean to someone with OCD? But making them want to harm themselves more. To this topic. I can talk to him about anything, just not trichotillomania, and I do not know why. It is not like he judges me, but I always feel ashamed about it. This is why I decided to do this robot voice generator and not be in front of the camera, because I am not ready to be so vocal about it yet. I do hope I will get the confidence I need and want to be more open about it besides just on my blog. It is one thing to write about it, but making a video makes you feel exposed to the world. And the world is not nice about these mental issues. I have never known anyone else who struggled with it. But I have been looking on Instagram and see there is a community for trick, and that makes me feel not so alone. I just wish someone struggling with OCD and trichotillomania reads my blogs on my website www.obsessedocdlife.com and would respond to me. I want to help others like me and be supportive and maybe help myself as well. And I can't get anyone to respond to my questions on my blog. Yet lots of people read them. The only response I have gotten is trolls making me feel worst about my OCD. And being told it is easier to stop than to get off my pity party. But I bet they did not struggle with trichotillomania as long as I have, 22 years. But back to what I was saying. I have been under a lot of stress trying to find a job and finding out we are on the edge of losing our property. But the reasons are unbelievable. It is not like we do not have the money to pay the house note, but the bank would not let him pay after we told them his parents passes away. Then they took 6 weeks getting all the paperwork right where Jason could pay it, and by then they said it had been foreclosed on. So to the lawyers, we are going. Now all around us is being developed, and so we and the lawyer think they are doing this to get a steal of a deal on our property. We own over $100,000 and the bank could make 4 times that. And we knew someone could pay someone else's house note because it has happened to us. Anonymously. So it is all kind of crazy. And getting a job when I have not been in public without covering my hair in about 3 or 4 years. I do wear wigs sometimes, but I do not know what I am doing wearing wigs. And wigs make me hot. I have worn wigs before at jobs, but I ruin them from getting so hot and the hair gets so tangled I cannot save them after a few times of that. So I have a lot of worries there. But I know I need to do things differently or things will not change. For insanity is doing the same thing over and over and expecting different results, and I want to stop this. For too long have I let trichotillomania rule my life, missing out when I could be in the middle with my kid. It has been years since I felt like I could swim with a care in the world or have to worry about my hat or bandana coming off and showing the bald spots on my hair. Even when I have pulled for a long time, I still think about it. I feel ashamed, but I cannot stop myself. I also try to not get my picture taken because I feel awkward and ugly, my confidence is low. And always struggled with body image. Going without eating for long periods of time or eating very little just to lose weight. So please leave me a comment and check out my website. I would really like to become friends with someone struggling with trichotillomania or some other form of BFRB. Thanks for watching, and until next time. Be kind to one another. You don't know what's going on in their lives.